Then again, I watched Samaj and the other boy.
I watched one with Brian and
Alright, so when we gonna start? After her, or she about to be drinking during the video?
No, I'm not.
Let's get on the way too. Let's get it over with, cause let's get on the way. Fuck you boys. I got a big fuck. You're not waiting. Fuck what? You tell me on my ass. All I like to do is get money. Fuck hoes. Kill this great shit. I'll be 64 hoes. That's the same reason why I killed you. Oh, he dead. Fuck. I'll be the two. He ain't had the same luck. Why are you gonna do? Get your whole head speaking down on the G. TJ on the ranch in the SRT on the tape. We just pulled up another eight, bro. I hate when rat hoes start acting fake. Forever, my brother keeping me in dreams. We don't really do shit down on my kids. Y'all, you gotta chill, my little.
What's up, y'all? Welcome to the interview, the number one podcast in Detroit, where we host athletes, rappers, entrepreneurs, and much more. If you want to interview, DM my page, the interview, and like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Right now, I'm here with the owner of Nails by
Dechon.
And
I Cam.
Gang.
Gang.
They about to talk about their little business they got going on. But first, how y'all been, though? How y'all been?
Good. How are you?
Yeah, y'all know I've been straight.
Okay, I know that's right.
Right.
Yeah.
She fake, though. I haven't seen her in a minute. I've been seeing her.
Where you been seeing her?
Out. Outside.
I'm a homebody now. Girl. I don't go out. You
be with who you
want to
be with.
No, I'm a homebody.
Where I got to speak up. But talk about what you got to offer at your nail spot.
So I do full sets, manicures, shellac on natural nails, and toes. I do toes.
Shellac or
it's
get
really
smacked.
Whatever. Yeah, shellac or get smacked. Period.
Where'd that come from? Because I be hearing everybody say that.
You know, the rats, but I hang out. I like the line, though.
That was a long time ago that came out, right?
Shellac or get smacked.
Yeah.
I wonder why they say that get smacked, though.
Yeah. Okay.
What about your business?
I do eyelash extensions, so hybrid, classic, volume, all of that. I also do lash lifts, and I do fill-ins, too, for my regular clients. And,
so we went off to school. Was that like a good little side hustle?
I didn't do it because I didn't have nowhere to do it. And I just felt like I don't want people in my room, you know? And so I'm used to having my own suite. So I'm just like, I'm not going to do it here. And COVID too. And I really don't want nobody in my bed. So
what about next year on campus?
I'm for sure on that. Yeah, I'm working on that now. So I'm getting a suite to work in and getting all that stuff set up.
So when you start doing nails? A while ago.
I started doing nails like 2 years ago, like 2019 for sure, like middle of 2019. So it's been 2 years.
Was it like a little influence, or you just knew you could do nails?
I ain't gonna say I knew I could do nails, but like I've been had an interest in nails. Like I've been like polishing my own nails since I was little, like sitting on the porch polishing my own nails. But then I stopped. Cause like you get older, you like going to the nail shop. But like my mama just asked me one day, like, you want to do nails? And sure, I don't know why I said yes, but I did. And here we go.
Here we go. 2 years later, got our own. They got their spot together. Y'all gotta tell them where it's at so they can book y'all.
2880 Southfield Road.
Just put the play on the side.
Yeah.
It's in Southfield.
they putting all these coordinates, like y'all gonna know what they talking about.
Southfield, we're in a very central, popular area. There's lots of hairstylists, people that have their own businesses, like all around us. So it's very safe. It's a good vibe there, and we professional. So don't worry about waiting 2 hours to get your stuff done. It won't happen there.
Or you didn't spend none of that.
Yeah, none of that.
I was just gonna ask that. Y'all them
we don't play that.
Oh, okay.
Even if we was, ain't nobody gonna admit to it. But we don't play that though.
No.
Cause like, I don't like that type of stuff.
I see girls all the time post like, this hairdresser, I'm professional as hell.
That
me
was
waiting
me. I
get for like
all
an hour, 2 hours.
I really think for the most part, it's the hairstylists that do that though. I ain't gonna say people in the other parts ain't a professional too, but it's for sure mainly the hairstylists.
Don't they be backed up though, probably?
Okay, that's
well,
cool.
Well, yeah. But it'd be people that don't show up. Like for my open house, person didn't even show up.
But you wouldn't be behind if you were like on
Wait,
time.
What did you do?
My cousin did my hair.
Oh,
but
okay.
Yeah, it was still like
That's so unprofessional. And it be on important days. Like, I get my hair done by random people on important days, which probably not smart, but yeah. And when you need them the most, then they'll be there. But that's not like how that's, we don't like, we're not gonna do that.
She can hear her feelings.
Bro, cause it do make me upset that people do me like that. I be so scared to get my hair done by people.
When you start doing like lashes and eyebrows and stuff?
I took my class in February of 2019, but I was terrible at it. So like, I didn't leave the house doing nobody lashes until what, like July?
Yeah,
2020?
2019.
Oh, okay.
It took me, how many months is that? Like 3-4 months, right? And yeah, cause I was terrible at it. I barely passed the class, honestly.
It's not easy though, is it?
No, it's not easy. It looks a lot easier than what it is. So you think it's easy, and then
so don't try it, basically.
Yeah, don't try it, because I'm the only one that can do it. I'm just kidding. But yeah, so July, my friends was like, bro, we want our lashes done. Like, come on. So I started doing people. And, you know, my pictures back in the day to now was just, like, crazy. Like, why would anybody ever pay for this? Like, it was like, 5 lashes on the eyes. But so you got to start somewhere. So, yeah, that's where I started. And here I am today.
So whose idea was it to, like, start y'all businesses together and get that spot?
Yeah, that's really how it happened. She did my lashes. Was that for my birthday? Or
I know it was around. Yeah, it was. But you had that curly hair.
Yeah, like I can't even think.
It was in July when I started.
It was, but like she was getting in. She had come to you to do your lashes, so she.
Yeah, I was a traveling.
I was doing nails at the house too, but I knew a spot that I wanted to go to. But like back then, like I ain't had no large clientele to be able to like pay the rent and still have the money that I'm making. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, yeah. And I'm thinking like, the way our shop set up, like it's a big room. It's just like suite. What's that called? We closed off, but like it's for 2 people to room in.
It's like a wall that like that separates us, but not
we
a
in
door.
The same room.
Yeah, so like, I can hear her and I can walk to see her. Like it's not separate. Like we together. But
anyways,
like, we have our own privacy.
It was perfect for 2.
Yeah.
So yeah, like that just made everything easier, and I feel like we both wanted to be in the spots in the central location. So boom, that's how that happened.
Nothing.
Was it a point you realized like your nail game is hard, and like you one of the best nail techs in the city?
Wait, let's start that question. Start that over.
I said, was it a point where you realized like, dang, I'm one of the best nail techs in the city? Like, it's not.
I don't think I'm really cocky, like where like I'm the best, but like every time somebody comes to me or coming back, they do like be telling me that. So like, yeah, I would be looking like, dang, yeah, I kind of am. But like, I'm not cocky about it. Like, I know my work good, but I don't know. It's always room for improvement. But yeah, my clients geek me, of course. You know, they be like, they don't play, cause I don't.
They don't play.
I don't.
They don't play, man. You heard it here first.
We saying they.
Like the D-A-E, but we don't play either.
Cause
Cam don't play
either.
But
they don't play. But I'm saying my clients
always let me know.
I don't play.
They don't play and they don't play.
Okay.
Yeah.
You
still heard it here first. Right. Mm-hmm. We got exclusives. So is it like a favorite design you got? Out of all the ones you did, cause I know you did a million nails. And
I think like, I do got a lot of different designs I like, but like I recently just did some nails. I think they was real sweet. Like I'm trying to step out my comfort zone. I usually just do like basic sets and stuff, but I've been starting to do like hand painted designs, 3D art and stuff. So I just did some. We're gonna show y'all. They sweet. Like it had clouds on there, smiley face on there. What else I have on there? It was a lot going on, but it was really cute. It was my first time doing it.
I've been seeing
your artistic too. Like you showed your skills.
Yeah, thank you.
Did y'all saw that one girl who had her nails on? She had like, I think she had money in her nails. Like she had a real.
She did the money nail before too. But what's your?
It was a real, like $20 bill, and they cut it up and all that.
Listen, I cut your $20 bill. Bring me a $20 bill. We can cut it up.
I'm not cutting mine.
I be usually telling people bring $1 bill. Like don't nobody care about $1.
Yeah, but $20.
Nah, it was 20. We finna be 20 next year.
Hey, crazy. My family be asking me, am I turning 20 this year? So I am. Since they keep telling me I am.
I mean, I'm 21 already, but.
Right?
So I saw you had posted that reel about keeping your lashes and stuff all shampooed.
Oh, yeah, my all lavish. TikTok.
Mm-hmm. What's 3 good tips for the viewers to keeping your lashes clean, healthy?
That's a good question. First, definitely lash baths are very important. I make my own and I sell them, but you can also get them on Amazon and stuff. And so you're gonna want to make sure you're washing your lashes if you cry, if you sweat, or just like daily, like not daily but every other day, often, because a lot of oil and stuff builds up and sometimes your eyes might water. Like my eyes water when I lay my head down. So the water makes your fan kind of close up and it look, you start looking like a spider a little bit by the eyes. So you gotta wash them and they return to their fluff and you back to your natural state. Another one is to not lay on your face. Now, I lay on my face, but it's not good for your lashes though. So if you can try not to, then don't. And then a third one is to not pull your lashes out because your natural lashes. It's glued to your eyelash. So if you're pulling it out, you're taking your eyelash with it. So people be like, I was bald after. I asked them, did you pull your eyelashes out? Yeah, that's what happened. So if you do that, you're going to be bald and it's not my fault. So, yeah. Well, let them fall out. And if you want them to come out sooner, use a little baby oil and massage it. But don't yank your lashes.
Or honestly, just come get a removal.
Yeah, or you can come get a removal. I have a removal service. I have a removal service. So that takes them off properly. There's no pulling. There's no yanking. And your lashes are going to be the exact same as when you put the lashes on. So, yeah, do that.
So y'all know how, like, everybody always be like, man, I don't know about that nail tech. They just might be like any other nail tech, or she might be like any other girl who do lashes. What can y'all clients, y'all new clients, expect from y'all?
You
want to
go first? You can expect professionalism from me. Like, I'm going to be on time. I'm not going to spin you. If it's ever anything that I need to say to you, I'm going to text you. Like, reminder, whatever. Well, you'll get a reminder the day before. On top of that, I'm not gonna make you text me to remind me you got an appointment. Like,
that's so,
I don't like
ghetto.
That.
Don't tell me to text you for a confirmation and I'll get
like,
the service.
And on top of that, you paying me a deposit, so I'm not gonna just take your money and run with it. Like, you pay me your deposit, you got an appointment. Like it said, you're fine. I'm not spending you none of no funny business with me. Like, you got your appointment, you got your appointment.
The deposit holds your spot. What's the point of me texting to see if you're gonna come? You paid for your deposit. If you don't come, on to the next, okay?
Yeah, and all the being late stuff, no, I'll be there. If you late, you can let me know. Like, just let me know you're running late. You might still have your appointment. But if you don't say nothing,
That late fee. Don't play about that late fee.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a late fee?
Yeah.
You got 10 minutes. Well, really, really, I give you 15 for real.
Like,
I give you 15 for real. But even, really, I be real lenient. I shouldn't be telling you all this, but I be real lenient. Like, just come on. If you're running late, let me know, whatever. You still got your... Don't push it. Don't go over 20.
Don't come
30
late.
Minutes late and stuff.
And then act like shit sweet.
But the thing is, like, it make me be behind. That's my thing. So, now you make me late for my client after you. Mm-hmm. That's not cool for them. Like, then that put more pressure on me. You want your nails there, right? I want to take my time on you, like... Yeah.
If you late, your nails not gonna be great.
No, that's a good one, but nah, they still gonna be straight.
And for me, like, it depends on if I got a break between you and my next client too. Like, if you gonna be 15 minutes late and I got a 15 minute break, okay. But if you 30 minutes late and I got somebody right after you, it's bad. Like, your deposit is gone and your appointment is gone. I mean, nothing I could do. I'm not gonna make my next client late and make me behind because you took your time coming to your appointment that you booked for. They didn't do nothing to me, so they gonna be first. And if you come when I'm serious with them, oh well, it's nothing I can do for you.
Yeah, be considerate with our time. We gonna be considerate with yours.
Yeah, we don't play like that.
Y'all know where to get y'all nails did. Y'all know where to get y'all lashes and eyebrows did.
Oh, I was gonna say, for me, a lot of people have red eyes, and I don't do that. So, like, that's when you get glue in your eyes.
Yeah, I'm seeing the red eyes. I'm like, they look hot. Everybody go to the, everybody, huh?
Yeah.
But that's
the No, that happened to me my first time getting lashes done, y'all, and I had the worst experience. My eyes was bloodshot red on my open house. They had a bad day on my open house, didn't I?
You said your hair wasn't good, your lashes wasn't right.
My eyes was bloodshot red. Everybody kept asking me, was I high at my own open house? Like,
I did ask you that.
Yes, everybody was asking
me. I'm like, damn.
My eyes was so messed up.
In front of the family?
Yeah. But getting glue in your eyes damages your eyes for days. And it could be worse if you get a lot in your eyes, too. So
it burns so bad.
And it burns. And so if you are getting, like, glue in your eye, let your lash tech know. Even if I'm not doing lashes, let them know because it's going to hurt for days, literally. So don't be scared. Tell them, like, hey, my eye burning. They're going to give you a fan. And if they don't, then just go ahead and pack up.
And ask for your refund.
Yeah, because you're about to get blue in my eye. That damages your eyes for real. Like, so you can expect that from me as well. And professionalism, of course.
All right, today's promo is Pressable Apparel. I'm gonna put the link in the description. This is a black business. He do trucker hats, shirts, jeans, hoodies, whatever you need. Support black niggas. But now we about to get into toxic relationships.
What?
My favorite.
Your favorite?
My
favorite.
Oh, okay. I hope that you know what I was to
talk about. Nah, I'm gonna just start. Have y'all ever been in a toxic relationship?
Yes.
So what makes the relationship toxic for the people that don't know? Because like everybody say they've been toxic, but I've been in some real toxic shit.
Yeah.
You go first. I think you should go first.
I went first last time, so.
Oh, when?
What question?
On the last video, y'all watched this. Y'all watched the video already. But next.
You got it.
Y'all
better
rock, paper, scissors.
Three,
rock, paper, scissors. One.
Shoot.
No, we only doing
just
one.
Ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Damn. I just knew she was about
to out scissors. Yeah, I did before. Yeah, I'm not slow. Come on.
So, what made your relationship toxic, Miss Day?
What made my relationship toxic?
Or what makes a relationship toxic?
Just throw it all out there.
I don't know about all of it, but what make a relationship toxic? The nigga.
I say the girl.
I'm trying to think. Continually, I think what make it toxic. I think when a relationship toxic is when somebody want to keep saying what they did was mistakes. But if you keep, okay, it's cool. People make mistakes. But if you keep doing that same thing, the same exact thing that you said was a mistake over and over and over, that's no longer a mistake. It's your choice.
That's a habit. Like,
that's your lifestyle. That's what you do for a living.
Yeah.
What about you?
Damn, that was good. That's not even a choice. It's a habit.
Yeah.
So I just, yeah.
Period.
Damn. It's a habit.
Yeah. I feel like when a relationship toxic, it's just not, like, you just not, it's just not the same as it was in the beginning. Like, y'all constantly arguing. You constantly unhappy. You just
so
question.
I'm glad I'm single. Like,
y'all not even elevating. Like, y'all still
like, you just feel like you stuck. Like, you just stuck. It ain't getting no better. And it's just like, why are we even here anymore? But something just keeps pulling you back into that love you got for me.
Cam, you making my heart pop out.
Yeah, you know, the love just keep you there, but you know it's a bad situation, and y'all just going back and forth like tug of war, like trying to let each other go, but you just can't, and it just get worse and worse. It is not good for the body.
I feel like you're talking about my relationship.
Cause I'm sorry, but these men are trash, and I want them not to be, but they are. And it's not even just your age or my age. It's 40, 50, 60, 80 year old men that's still trash.
But it's also good men, like the one you're looking at. Who will treat you right?
Like, this is what they do. Treated. They put on a fake face and they lie to you, girl.
Ain't nothing fake about this, baby. But no.
But for real, yeah.
So find you a good one. What do girls look for in a guy? Because Detroit girls normally look for the scat packs, the jewelry.
I know somebody that looks
the designer. So I'm like, what do y'all look for?
I personally don't think I really look for nothing. I personally don't think I look for nothing. But, I mean, I don't know, y'all. I don't want to say
nothing. Shit, it's what you look for in a guy. What they gonna judge?
Really, I'm not looking for nothing. I'm waiting to get found.
Yes.
So, that's really my answer.
Because you are the catch.
But girls be lit when any nigga slide, they for sure. I got a boyfriend. I'm straight on you. So like, how are they gonna find you if you not to be found?
Are you supposed
to do that? I know you would be homing out here.
That's a good point.
I mean, like, you can just ain't gonna say you just look at somebody and know you ain't feeling it, but I mean, yeah, like, I think appearance does matter. Like, you ain't gotta be a designer, but I mean, like, it's just a certain look. Like, you gotta look nice up some part, but I mean, or like, sometimes it be the hair for me, like.
Bro, the hair.
Y'all don't like that twist?
I'm trying on dress for real, but I can't even lie, cause
I don't know.
I ain't even see. I got a little
the free form. You don't want, you ain't never combed your hair in your life. Get it away from me because it stank and it's stuff falling out of it as well. I'm straight.
No. Listen, it's also how you approach me too, though. That's how I'm gonna know too. Like, dang, he got game. I'm just gonna give him my number. Or like, it depends on what you say. Like, mm-hmm. off what you say or how you type it.
If a nigga say text me, no. Hello?
He like, text me. No, like, what you trying to do?
People don't know where to text me.
You're like, how did you even get to my page, sir?
Yeah, hello, how are you?
If this ain't you, ain't posted nothing.
Yeah, no. Don't say text me.
Y'all guys out there, y'all better be listening. They been telling y'all.
This is free game.
Free game. Like, free.
For me, what I'm looking for, definitely, like, don't be too nice. Like too, you know, I don't want a pushover. Like somebody said, I want your masculine energy to outweigh my masculine energy so it can bring out my feminine energy. That's what it is. You get it? Basically, I want you to be more dominant over me. Not saying like you
a
boss
of me.
Yeah, but like show that you a man and you have those qualities that, you know, I feel like you can take care of me, or like you gonna protect me. Like, I don't want no nigga ever to hide behind me if he sees some guns or something like that. Like, yeah. No, you need to be making sure I'm straight.
Yeah, block
you
me.
Know?
But wait, this one thing I am looking for. I like my type, my love language, the energy I like, I don't like having to ask for nothing. Like, I feel like if he wanted to, he would.
Mm-hmm.
So there tweet. It is. Oh, yeah.
I did have a
tweet.
But
I really believe that.
So like, you wouldn't be spoiled.
It don't even have none to be me and spoiled, like, attention or whatever. Like, I shouldn't have to ask for none of that.
Yeah, you deserve that, for sure.
So, that's what everything. I'm not talking about
young,
it's none of that.
Black women, for respect.
What if, like, you got plans with your mans, and I say I want you to come over? Then what?
When was this plan? Like, it was like I was just driving, they, like, pull up to the crib, and then you was, like, pull up to my crib. Yeah, I'm gonna go to your crib. But if it was like we planned this event or something, we was going to the club Saturday, and then now you like, I want you to stay home Saturday. And I'm like, why you didn't say that when I was asking you?
You should be at home.
I mean, if she can go to the club by herself, why can't
I? If you don't have a problem with her going to the club at that time, that's cool. But if I want you to be at home at that moment, that day, okay? I obviously want you for something.
Six.
No!
That's it.
Like, what if I want to go do something with you? Like, I want to go out to eat or something, or I wanted to go to this special place.
We can do that any day of the week. Cause I'm with
what
you
if they only open on this day?
Well, that would never happen.
It's a one-time pop-up shop.
See, but for girls be trying to make something out of nothing.
That is
nothing. That's why I should be like, girls, try to chill out sometimes. Let God do us. We let y'all do you. But y'all got to chill out. Stop stressing us.
I'm out here with three jobs. You out here at home playing a game all day? No, I'm straight. You don't have no form of income.
Yeah. You can't be out here just bumming.
Yeah.
Come on now. Mm-hmm. All this cheese coming around, you still don't got none.
Yeah, look, I don't even, I mean, like.
you watching this, like. Damn, he right. I still don't got no cheese.
You sitting at home. You ain't got no job. You ain't getting no money. Come work at Everest.
Come work here. I got a job. Come work at the shop. Yeah. Sweep.
Sweep the floor. Yeah.
Go sweep.
$10 a day.
Yeah.
All right, this is a part of the interview where I say a name and y'all say the first word that come to mind. All right.
Wait, what? At the same time?
You say a name.
No, I'm going to say a name and y'all say the first word that come in your head.
We both say it at the same time, we're taking turns.
It don't matter. But like, I'm going to say the name and y'all be like,
Okay.
Pooh Shiesty.
My dog.
Yeah, I was
going to
say that's my dog.
I thought y'all was going to say Big Boo.
I don't know how to say it.
I'm not saying it either.
Bro, he gets a little Gucci to me.
All right.
Lil
Durk.
Now, that's a respectful man.
India.
Oh, my God. They caught up in the hype.
Nah.
Who was? What's the hype?
everybody.
I just like how he treat her. Nah, I like.
Y'all don't know what's
her.
Going on
you
behind
don't
the
know,
scenes.
Okay, you don't know what's going on behind the scenes, but to, if he not embarrassing her in public.
Mm-hmm. So little baby and embarrassing.
He be embarrassing her. Yeah.
I don't blame her for not leaving though, because if any girl was in that situation, they not leaving the hottest rapper out. They not.
She could go mess with
We'll let her decide. Okay.
Not you.
Damn, not me. I'm not good enough.
You're just like a minor compared to her. That's all.
Wow.
She might be a cool girl. We don't know.
Bro.
We really like the same age. I told you.
I forgot you was 21.
Yeah, I'm 21. Okay. She like 25.
Okay, that's straight.
So let's get back. Justin LaBoy, or whatever his name is.
Respectfully.
That was a good one.
Yeah. Respectfully, that's right.
Babyface Ray.
Allowance. You don't like him or something?
Babyface. I
think
I should say.
For two dub.
False.
Big booty.
I know y'all seen
Jazz, if you listening, girl.
Where the cups at?
NBA Young Boy.
In jail.
Baby mamas.
Lil George.
Who was that?
One Hit Wonder. What was the song he makes? What do you say?
Who was Lil George?
Damn. Lil George, I feel bad for you, bro.
What
if you watching
what's
this.
What's that one song?
My bad,
I got the sauce.
Alright, this is the last name. Khalil. If y'all didn't know, that's my name. One word. Let y'all think.
Cool.
Basic.
I was gonna say a businessman,
yeah,
like you on your way up.
Businessman, thank you, Kev.
Of course, you know. She tried to come from.
She just tried to diss me.
Yeah.
Cool. How many niggas? How many niggas I heard cool? At least I ain't no lame.
All right, what first name word to come to mind when you say Kim?
On her shit. She been on her shit. I can't lie.
One thing I do, I might play, you know. But I always been on my shit.
Yeah, she been on my shit.
Okay, for Day. The one that you
didn't have
no work
for
me.
For
me or for Day?
For her.
Day, you didn't have no work for me.
You asked him.
I was talking about both of y'all.
You definitely right, said him. But a word for you. The first one, I was trying to think harder. But the first word that came to my mind thinking of Cam is like considerate. I just feel like she a really nice person.
That shit is so big, bro. People really not considerate. Yeah. And it blow my mind because I'm considerate. And I'd be like, damn, you really wouldn't do that for them days?
She real soft-hearted. I like that about her. Is that a word?
All right. The first word for her. First, I was saying turn. She always been turn since I met her.
Always been turn. She trying to she want to
I didn't calm down, though. I said I was a homebody in the beginning.
Homebody.
No.
Left me hanging, but it's cool.
Oh, just now?
Yeah, just
her back was to you kind of
disappointed. Yeah.
I would say, I don't know, I feel like you complex. I don't know if that's like a good word to say.
My other one was funny.
Oh. She only funny when she wanted me. But don't get on her bad side because
it ain't cute.
Then she gets acting crazy. That's the other layer of her.
So you heard what they said. Get your nails done by her.
Period.
Get your lashes done by her.
Period.
Stop being toxic and bring something to the table in a relationship.
What you got next for us? What's the next interview that's coming up next?
They gonna see it next week. Next week, y'all might get a D1 basketball player. Y'all might get a blue check rapper.
Ooh, so, okay.
It's really like, I'm dead ass though.
But, tap in with my boy.
Man, for real. But thank you all for coming on the interview. Like I said, like, comment, and subscribe. If you want an interview, DM me, DM my page, follow my page, subscribe to my YouTube, all that. And we just going to keep coming with bangers, man.
Are you
going to
put our tag on here, or should we say it?
All their tags in the description, right below.
Period.
We out.
Bye.
But I ain't write no music. Tell that bitch to get back with her man. Like I was cute, but you can't mix that shit with your bare hands. Might try to use how the fuck I'ma cuff you, know you fuck my mans. You sound a stupid nigga, ain't in the fig. Just be rapping about the crimes I'm doing. You know I can't.